موچوم کر شہ نے کہا لوئے سکینہ الوداع، موچوم کر شہ نے کہا لوئے سکینہ الوداع، بابا تیرا مرنے چلا لوئے سکینہ الوداع، اب ہم کہاں اور تم کہاں، دیکھیں گی کیا کیا خواریاں، مل لے گلے اے میری جان لوئے سکینہ الوداع، فضل خدا سے آج تک تابے رہے جن و ملک، اب تم ہو اور جور فلک لوئے سکینہ الوداع، اعوذ باللہ من الشیطان اللعین الرجیم، بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم، عزم اللہ اجورنا واجورکم بمصابنا بالحسین علیہ السلام، السلام على الحسين وعلى علي ابن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين، السلام على يا رسول الله، أحسن الله لك العطاء وفي ولادك الحسين عليه السلام. We are sending our condolences to our holy prophet, to Imam Ali, to Bibi Fatima, to Hassan Mujtaba, and to the Imam of our time.
As-salamu alayka ya Fatimata, ahsan Allah laka al-ada fi waladik al-Husayn alayhi salam. السلام عليك يا أمير المؤمنين، أحسن الله لك العطاء في ولدك الحسين. السلام عليك يا أبا محمد الحسن، أحسن الله لك العطاء في أخيك الحسين.
My brothers and sisters, today is the ultimum day of this holy month of Muharram, a day in which few hours Imam gave up everything.
No.
When we have just a member of our family whom we love, and if that person has to die, it becomes such a tragic event. But just imagine Janab-e Zainab. I want you to think about this lady. Because she, at the age of 5, saw the passing away of the Holy Prophet. She saw the passing away of her father, Ali ibn Abi Talib. She saw the passing away of her mother, Janabi Fatima al-Zahra. She was present at the time when Imam Hassan was vomiting the liver out of his mouth. She was present in Karbala to the extent that she saw the way Shimmer sat on the chest of her brother. Just imagine what this lady must have gone through. That is why it is said that Zainab lasted less than a year after the event of Karbala. She left this world. And today, as we remember Zainab and her zari, her mausoleum in Sham, we say assalamu alayki ya Zainab bint Ali. We ask Allah to give us the opportunity to bring peace back into Syria so we can visit the graves of Zainab and Sakina bint al-Husayn. It was the day of Ashura. Imam had just completed the burial of Ali Asghar. Now he first goes to the enemies, and he wanted to make sure that nobody would ever say that I did not know who I was standing against. Imam goes and introduces himself to the army of Yazid and said, I am that Hussein who is the son of Fatima al-Zahra salamullah alayhi. But one thing very important, Imam said when he came back, when somebody asked him, Baba, why aren't they listening to what you are saying? You should always remember this particular reply of Imam. He said, the reason they could not understand me is because their stomach is full of najasat. My brothers and sisters, when Hussein wanted to go to the khayma of Imam Zainul Abidin, so he said to his sister Zainab, oh Zainab, come along with me. When they arrived in the tent of Imam Zainul Abidin, Janab Zainab started to wake up as he was very sick on the bed, Imam Zainul Abidin, so he decided to wake him up. Historians say that at never time of any Imam, the Imamat was handled the way Imam Hussein handed over to Imam Zainul Abidin. He shook him up, Janab Zainab shook Imam Zainul Abidin and said, my son, look at who is in front of you today. Well, Imam Hussein looked at Imam Zainul Abidin. Imam himself said that the moment I woke up and I saw the face of my father, but I did not recognize it. He said, I did not recognize it because his face was full of blood and dust was on his face. For a moment, I just looked at him, and then when he said, my son, that is when I recognized that this was my father. But the first thing Imam Zainul Abidin asked, Baba, where is Abul Fazlil Abbas? He said, Abbas, Qad Qutila, Abbas, and gave up his life. Then he said, Baba, where is Ali Akbar? Imam said, he has left us too. Then he said, Baba, where is Qasim or Muhammad? And Imam said, listen, my son, listen. Besides me and you, there is nobody left. At that moment, Imam Zainul Abidin says to Janab Hussain, give me my stick. He tries to stand up and he stood up. He said, I will go and now fight for the sake of my father. Imam says, Ali, no, Ali. Sit down. There's one thing he said at that time. He said, Baba, is there any way for us to go back to Medina? He said, is there any way we can take Zainab and all the ladies and children back to Medina? Imam said, there is no other way, my son. You will have to lead the caravan from Karbala to Kufa. From Kufa to Sham and Sham to Karbala, back to Medina. At that moment, Imam consoled him and he then said to Zainab, there is few things I want to give you as a wasiya. Janab Zainab said, my brother, please tell me what is he? He said, Zainab, when you ever see any water coming back to the Khaymah, before anything, make sure you give water to my little Sakina. And then he said to Ali Zainul Abidin, my son, if you ever, whenever you get to Medina, give my Shia my salam and tell them that whenever they drink water, to always remember me. And then he said that whenever they come to Karbala, he had told the people of Bani Asad that whenever a Zawar would come to Karbala, treat them as my guests in Karbala. After that, he says to Janab Zainab, can you lift the clothing you have on your shoulder? will kiss his that shoulder. And he said, do you know my father Ali ibn Abi Talib? Our father had said, then, oh my son Hussein, when time comes and you are leaving, make sure you kiss the shoulders of Zainab. For it is the shoulders that will be tied up with ropes and chains. That is why Allama Majlisi says that once, just before the Majalis of Roze Ashur, I was just sitting near the Zari of Imam, and suddenly I went to sleep. In the sleep, I saw a man come over to me and say, Sheikh, today when you recite the Shahadat of Imam Hussein, Janab Fatimatu Zahra has asked one particular portion to always recite. And Allama Majlisi said, what is that portion that you want me to recite? He said, Fatima, I said, that is the most difficult thing that Fatima had ever experienced, and that was the farewell of Hussein. I want you to think all these people's heart and mind was on Hussein. When Hussein comes for the farewell, just imagine what must have gone through the hearts of all the ladies and children. Imam Jalali Zainab said, my brother, can you please lean down? She leans down and Zainab kisses the neck of Imam Hussein. And Imam said, why? And Zainab, she said, the day when our mother was going, she had told me that Zainab, if ever Hussein came for his last farewell, remember to kiss his neck for my behalf. Imam then called Janab Fizza, whom he always regarded as a mother, and said, Fizza, I am bidding farewell to you. Thank you for all the services that you had provided to my family. Fizza says, I remember the day when one day when in the madrasa the Holy Prophet had heard a voice. He thought it was Hussein crying when he asked the teacher, whose voice is this? He said, it is similar to Hussein. And the Holy Prophet said, do not tell anything to this child, for he reminds me of Hussein. Janab Fizza, farewell. Imam sits on the horse and he says to Zuljana, Zuljana, you know where to take me now, let us go. But for a moment the horse looked down on the floor and he wouldn't move. And Imam said, Zuljana, I need your help, let us move. He wouldn't move, and at that very moment Imam looks down and he sees the four-year-old girl holding to the legs of the horses. She was holding on to the legs of this horse, and at that moment Imam came down the horse and said, Sakina, allow me to leave. And she said, Baba, I know everyone who has left the Khaimah has never returned back.
I know, Baba, you will not be coming back. But as a child, as a daughter of yours, I am asking, can you please lie down on the ground? And Prabhu Sen says, my daughter, what do you want me to do? He said, lie down. He lies down and she puts her head on his chest. And she said, Baba, you have always made me sleep on your chest. I want to sleep today for the last time. And at that moment, Imam said, Sakina, can I ask you something? And he said, what? And she said, what? And Imam said, Sakina, tonight when the night falls, make sure you sleep near your mother, Ramah. For every night she used to sleep with Ali Azhar, today she's going to miss Ali Azhar. You will console her by sleeping next to her. Promise me, Sakina, you will always do that. Imam Hussein is now leaving and bidding farewell to Umm Kulsum, to Janab Zainab, Umm Farwah, and all the ladies. He then moved towards the battlefield of Karbala. And he arrives there when Hurmala was arrested by Mukhtar. Mukhtar had asked him, oh Hurmala, tell him the most, tell me what was most difficult time in the day of Ashura. He said, I had 3 arrows. I used 1 arrow to hit the eye of Hazrat Abul Fazlil Abbas. My 2nd arrow was an arrow that went through the neck of Ali Asghar. But my 3rd arrow went through the heart of Hussein. May Allah accept our azah. At that moment, Imam bids farewell and leaves. When he gets hit with the arrow of Zuljanam, suddenly he falls from the horse and he comes down. Umar ibn Sa'ad says, go ahead and finish him. There was a man who brought a spear and he held on to that spear and hit Imam Hussein. There was a young boy, Abdullah ibn Hassan. He was hardly 5 or 6 years of age. He was holding on to the hand of his mother, Janab Umm Farwah. But at that moment, he runs when he saw what they were doing to Hussein. He came down on his body and he turns and said, nobody's going to hit my... He said, nobody's going to hit my ankle. At that moment, one of the enemies took a sword and hit this child. Not only was Hussein in his last moment, he grabs this little child in his hand. Shimmer then says, it looks like nobody can do this job, so I will do it. He turns Imam Hussein the other way. He takes his knife out. And just imagine, he says, I could feel that Hussein's mother was there. The angels had come and picked off his head of Hussein from the lap of his mother and placed his head on the ground. Shimmer then uses his knife. I don't have the strength to tell you what happened. But there was a moment when Imam Zainul Abidin was still in the bed. Janab Zainab was there. Umme Kulsoom comes running and said, oh sister, look at what they're doing to our brother Hussein. My brothers and sisters in Islam, what were they doing? Shimmer is sitting on the chest of Imam. It is said that when Imam Zainul Abidin was in his last moments, when he was in his last moments, and Imam Muhammad al-Baqir alayhi salam was sitting next to him, at that moment there came a time when he put his head on the chest of his father, Imam Ali Zainul Abidin. Imam started to cry that moment and he said, why are you crying, Baba? He said, I'm crying because my son had the privilege to sleep on my chest. He said, I did not have the privilege of sleeping on my father's chest. My brothers and sisters in Islam, when Umme Kulsoom came and asked Zainab to see what they were doing, Zainab lifts up the curtain of the tent. There was a moment when she comes out of the tent and she's on a higher hill, which today in Karbala is known as Tilla-e-Zainabiyya. She stands on this mountain and she looks down. She notices Shimmer sitting on the chest of Imam Hussein. Zainab says, Ali Zainul Abidin, lift up the curtain of the tent and see what is transpiring. If you and when you go, may Allah give you that opportunity to go to Karbala, but you will see this place where Zainab stood. She was looking down at Imam Hussein. Now where his head was cut off, to where he is actually lying in his cover is so far apart. And so somebody asked, why did it? Usually they would have made the cover where his head was cut. He said, because they were riding the horses and they were kicking around the body of Hussein in such a way that it landed so far away from where the head was. At that moment, Janab Zainab says, my son lift up the curtain. And he lifts up and he said, As-salamu alayka ya Aba Abdullah. Jibrail Amin said, Ala qatl al-Husayn bi Karwala. Hussein's head was lifted on the spear. Ali Zain al-Abidin was looking at his father's head and said, Baba, my salams to you.
Why, Baba?
At that moment, Sakina runs out of her tent. She notices the horse is coming back, but it's all bloody. The horse comes near Imajanabe Sakina. There was one thing she asked this horse, nothing else. She said, Zuljana, when they killed my father, did they ever give him water prior to killing him? ألا لعنة الله على القوم الظالمين وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون رزا بقضائه وتسليما لأمره اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم بحق محمد وانت المحمود بحق علي وانت الأعلى بحق فاطمة وانت فاطر السماوات والأرض بحق الحسن وانت المحسن بحق الحسين وانت قديم الإحسان إلهي توبة قبل الموت وراحة عند الموت ومغفرة بعد الموت والنجاة من النار ودخولا في الجنة وعافية من كل بلاء الدنيا وعذاب الآخرة ماتم حسين.